Hey, Jonathan here. In today's video, I want to show you some even cooler ways of dealing with NA values within your data. On top of that, I also want to show you some really cool shortcuts for doing bulk operations against multiple columns. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. So this video here is based off a video I just produced recently showing one of my students how to fill in NA values. Now to do this, I basically use this function here, which is last observation carried forward. Now this particular function comes from the Zoo library, which is just one of the many libraries packaged up into tidyquant, which overall has hundreds of different functions for dealing with time series data. So it is a really fantastic library to work with. Now, one of my students pointed out to me that you could also use the function fill, which is actually just part of the tidyverse library. So that was pointed out by Julian. So thank you very much, Julian, for pointing that out to me, because fill is, of course, a very, very nice solution for this also. So another thing I used in here was I used the mutate function within if else function. Now if else is kind of nice, especially if you're coming from Excel, because it's just such a universal generic kind of function, which works the kind of same way. So in Excel, if you used if statement before, you've got if condition, if true, and then if false. So if else in R works exactly the same way. So if we run all this, you can see what all this looks like. It's just loading libraries. And here we can see we have our NA values being filled in the right over here. Okay, so let's take this again and let's see how would this look like if we use the fill function instead. So first of all, we can make this actually quite a bit shorter by going fill. And what we want to do is we want to type in the column name. So fill original, right? So if we do that, it just fills in the column for us. Fantastic, really nice shortcut there. Okay, now this function here, if else, there's actually a shortcut for this as well. So for example, let me copy this. And over here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do mutate again, filled equals NA if original. And quote marks there. So that basically, this function here basically looks for anything with empty quotes and replaces it with NA for us, which means then we can just come over here and type in fill original. Okay, but let's make this even cooler. So let's say we have multiple columns that we need to do this with. Is there a smarter, better way of doing this? Well, actually, yes, there is. So let me take this over here. And we right now we have one column. And so let's rename this to column, say, one. And over here, I'm going to copy this a few times. We just rename this column 2, 3, 4, 5. Just for interest, let's make this column a little bit different. Maybe let's make this numeric instead. I think I got 7 columns here. So 1, 2, 7. And I'll get a column that looks like this. Now, what I can do is I can use a tidyverse function called mutate all. So let me just make this a little bigger. So mutate all. And what this will do is it will modify all of the columns at the same time for me. So I'm going to give it a function. So we just use the NAIF function here. We can use it again. So let's stick that in there. And the second parameter of this will actually pass this condition into the NAIF. So I'm going to put in my empty quotes. This is actually for the NAIF function. And this here will convert all these to NAs. Again, why do we want all these to be NAs? Because then we can use the function with fill. Okay, now to make fill work with all of these columns at the same time, well, there's a few ways that we can do this. So first of all, you can actually type in multiple column names. So in here, I could do column 1, column 2, right? And that's going to work for those two columns there. there's another way I could do this. I could say 1, 2, 4, right? And then that's going to do it for all those columns there, columns 1 to 4. Or if I didn't know how many columns I had, the other thing I could do as well is I could just use the function names dot. And basically what this is going to do, it's going to get me the name of every single column. And then the dot is basically just a shorthand for this table. So this is going to get the names for all the columns for this table and then fill them. So let me run that. And there we go. It's just done it for all of the columns. So some really cool shortcuts there. Mutate all, NA if, fill, and names. So some really cool things that you can do with the Tidyverse library. So if you're interested in some more training, I've got free training over at my website, www.datastrategywithjonathan.com. I am updating that training soon. So if you check in soon, there's going to be some new updated training there as well. If you found this video helpful, please leave a thumbs up. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.